I got into this and the WWE and wrestling because I was a huge fan of it, but what made me successful at it was going to the gym, fitness. And I say all the time that the gym teaches you everything you need to know about life. The harder you work, the more you get out of it. You set a goal, you know what you need to do to achieve that goal, and you get in the gym, and you eat right, and you train hard, and with those goals, you can accomplish anything. So part of that for me is Arnold was my hero growing up, and you know, seeing what he did and the goals that he set with bodybuilding and everything that he did with movies and politics beyond that, that was inspiring to me, to make me go to the gym, to make me train, to make me realize that anything could be possible. To then go full circle and on the biggest stage ever to have Arnold, you know, be on screens and kind of play the game. And here it comes, it's just one of the coolest moments ever for me. And it was just an awesome experience to be able to pay back to me, a hero of mine, for what I feel is the success that he taught me to have.
I just want to make sure that everyone understands that even though we love watching wrestling, but I want you to go beyond watching. Remember, this Sports and Fitness Festival is all about you participating. We want to inspire each and every one of you. You. Everyone has to participate and exercise every day. I don't care what you do, but do something every day. Because remember, a body in motion stays in motion. And we want to be powerful to make sure that you go get to the chopper! So I just have to say one thing, though. So I'm just standing here watching it and cut that impassioned promo and get to the chopper. And all you notice is like, holy crap, look at his biceps still. Like he's jacked. It's awesome.
Thank you, thank you. Everybody work Snapchat.
Yeah. Snapchat time. Arnold Schnitzel, right?
Arnold Schnitzel. Here we are.
I'm right here with Triple H and Public Domain. I'm going to say thank you for holding me down on the Sports and Fitness Festival. These are my heroes. Yes!
I never thought I would see Arnold Schwarzenegger's Snapchat in the WWE ring. History is being made. So this has sort of become, over the last 2 years, a regular stop on the road to WrestleMania. Even compared to last year, this event has grown bigger and more fantastic. What's the future hold for this festival?
Well, it's very clear that sports and business is growing all the time, and the Arnold Classic is growing all the time, and the WWE is growing and growing and growing and growing and growing. And I love that. I love that it's growing. Yes! I love it. I love all of you. It's great to be back again. And of course, this year we're going to have over 200,000 people coming through here. We have 56 different sports, so this is really great. We have almost 20,000 competitors competing here this time in this next few days. So it's really the best and the biggest festival. And we have a number of WWE as part of it and joining and being partners of the Arnold Classic. It's absolute heaven. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Just a little bit here, you're going to see a bunch of athletes that are, you know, regular people, everyday people, to be standing next to you, probably were here last year, and they're going to stand in this ring and they're going to try out for WWE tonight. They're going to be coming in here and you're going to get to see a little taste of what it takes to get in the ring and become a WWE superstar, to become an NXT superstar. And I think it's going to be very inspiring to all of you to see what can be.
I have one personal question that's been on my mind for a while since I found out where you're doing this. You guys are known for your discipline in the gym and your team lifestyles and things like that. What do you need for achievements?
Well, this morning I got up early already and I was already for 1 hour in the gym and then the cardiovascular training, some weight training. But right after that,
if we're talking cheat meals,
talking all out. Like, yeah, I need to wait.
It depends on the day, but I'm a big breakfast guy, so for me, going pancakes and French toast and all the powerlifters just got hungry all at once. But you gotta cheat now and then, you gotta live life. You know, I know all this stuff is very strict, and Arnold when it's time to be strict, is very strict. But healthy fitness should also be fun. It's not a task, you know, it's not something that you have to go do. It should be miserable, it should be fun, it should be enjoyable in your life. Achieving those goals should be enjoyable, and part of that is letting yourself go every now and then and having that cheat meal, so it's good to do.
I know, it's really good, but I was one time at this health convention, and I heard someone say, just remember that what you eat is very important, because what you put in your body is exactly what it's going to look like. And so if you eat garbage, you're going to look like a garbage can. And I said to myself, oh my God, I don't want to look like a garbage can. So since then, I'm afraid of pancakes or anything bad.
Now, Harlow, I know you're a busy guy. You got a brand new venture. You can add TV hosts to this. Want to tell us a little about your apprentice track coming up?
Yes, I'm hosting this 11th apprentice. We just finished shooting it. It will come out this fall. It was a lot of fun doing that. I love new challenges. It's the first time I've done anything on reality television. So it was really great to go in and say, you fired. Well, you were terminated. Last one is the baby. Well, you coming back. Get with the chopper. And all those guys are just not going to do that.
Like Trump had one hand, you're fired. That looked like for babies. You got like a plethora of ways to fire people.
I have a huge inventory of different things, and no one knows yet which one will be the line that I'm going to use ultimately.
It's not a tumor!
It's not a tumor! It's not a tumor!
Anyway, have fun, guys.